So today is the full moon, and if you're looking to change up your routine of any type, this is the perfect time to do it. The full moon is all about letting go of what's no longer serving you so that you can make room for new habits. So I figured I would make a video showing you my full moon Pamper routine. And obviously my Pamper routine changes from month to month depending on what my intention is for that full moon. And because the moon is in Pisces this month, I'm feeling very much in my head, feeling a lot of emotions, and I just want to get grounded. So my intention for this Pamper session is to ground myself. When there's a full moon in Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio, our emotions and feelings are intensified because the moon is just controlling all of that water energy within us. Attuning your Pamper routine to match your inner needs does wonders, and doing this on a full moon is especially potent if you want to transform your hair, your skin, and to get rid of and eliminate old and negative habits. So like I said, my inner needs are telling me I really need to get grounded, so that's exactly what I'm going to be doing during this full moon Pamper sesh. Hey everyone, my name is Courtney Violetta and I'm what I would call a mystical millennial. I know that a lot of people nowadays are wanting to just take a second and step back from scrolling through social media mindlessly and just want to connect a little bit to something deeper. So the goal of my channel is to help encourage people to just think more open-mindedly about this crazy universe that we live in. So if you're into that kind of thing, be sure to subscribe and click the bell notification button so you never miss out on my two mystical videos a week. So with that said, let's just get on into our full moon Pamper routine. So for the full moon, since I really want to get grounded, I want to use products that are literally from the ground, from plants. So for this video specifically, I wanted to use my favorite company ever, Henna Sook, and their amazing masks. Cutting your hair on a full moon is the best time to do that. It yields healthier hair and enables your hair to just grow much faster because you're eliminating what's no longer serving you, as in the split ends of your hair. But since I just trimmed my hair a few days ago, I decided that a scalp treatment would be the best thing to do other than cut my hair to encourage some hair growth during the full moon cycle. During the full moon, I always put my crystals either outside or on my windowsill so they can get charged by the moon. I also put some rose quartz in a jar of water or in a container of water and seal it up and leave it outside for the moon to charge that water. Then throughout the following month, I'll use the water in different things like my skincare or my hair care, or I'll put like a tablespoon in my glass of water every day and just have some of that like magical moon water somehow every single day. So because I already had a little bit of this moon water left from the previous moon cycle, I put a little splash of this water into the hair mask, mixed it up. It made the consistency a lot thinner and easier to apply, so I was really happy that I did do that. Then I just wet my hair and applied the mask to my damp hair. This mask is supposed to strengthen the roots, the scalp, add moisture and condition the hair, and of course promote hair growth. Once I did that, I went on to do the Moroccan green clay mask. This is also from Henna Sook, and I did the exact same thing. I added my crystal infused moon water to the clay and mixed it all together, and then I applied it all over my face. I let the hair mask sit for about an hour and the face mask sit for about 20 minutes, and then I washed both of them off. The clay mask is supposed to remove impurities, tighten the pores, tone the skin, and reduce inflammation. I washed out the hair mask with just the Henna Sook co-wash, and I found it really easy to actually get off. It's way easier to get out than henna is, and this was the final result of both of those. My hair was so shiny and soft, and my hair definitely felt a lot thicker. I do feel as though you're able to see the benefits of the mask a few days later once you do shampoo and condition your hair again. And this is it a few days later after I literally just washed my hair this morning. It does feel so shiny and soft, and I can totally see the benefits of this mask working on my hair. The face mask made my skin feel so nice and soft, and it definitely did feel tightened. After doing both of those, I sprayed lots of Henna Sook rose water. This rose water is my favorite. I use it before putting makeup on. I use it to set my makeup. I use it before putting on moisturizer, and it is just amazing. It doesn't smell too fragrancy like a lot of other ones that I have tend to do. It just smells very earthy and grounding, which is exactly why I wanted to use this one on my face today. But if you're interested in any of the products that I'm mentioning in this video, I'll link them in the description box down below so you can check them out for yourself. After I did my hair care and my skincare, I decided I really just wanted to wash my bedding. That's something I don't do enough, and there's nothing better than getting into bed with clean sheets, and doing this on the full moon sets an intention of peaceful sleep for the next moon cycle. So this is something that I do tend to do on full moons, even though, like I said, I'm not the best at remembering it. So while my bedding was in the wash, I decided I wanted to do a little bit of a meditation and do a forgiveness letter ritual. This is something that I find so helpful in releasing. It releases the negative energy that I might be holding on to right at the full moon. So it's amazing. I highly recommend everyone do this. And for this, I did a little meditation to ask for myself to be able to tap into my higher mind and to be able to see situations in my life from the highest perspective possible. And in order to practice just a little bit of gratitude from the day and to just ultimately raise my vibration. Then what I did was I wrote a forgiveness letter. I'm someone who finds forgiveness very challenging, and while I can forgive, it's really hard for me to forget. And honestly, it's really hard for me because I find it super easy to just cut people out of my life, and I need to learn to like realize that people make mistakes. Otherwise, I'll be like alone in my life forever. So I feel that writing forgiveness letters is a way to see a situation from the highest perspective and allow myself to really understand why people do the things that they do, which might save me from cutting out a really valuable person to my life. So forgiveness letters is a way to practice softening your need for a different past. Instead, you place your point of power in the present moment. You learn to love your life in the here and now rather than feeling the energy of the initial insult or the situation. This is something that I find really powerful, and it's the willingness to forgive can exist while you're not ready to forgive. But writing a forgiveness letter is a way to gift yourself with the emotional and spiritual freedom that you deserve rather than dwelling on hurtful events that really just take up space in your energy field. So since the full moon is all about releasing things that are no longer serving us, this is the best time to write a forgiveness letter because you're releasing those negative energies that are no longer serving you. So for this full moon, I wrote a letter to someone who I'm currently in a little drawn out argument with. And the most important thing to remember when writing these letters is to recall the incident or argument and allow yourself to feel the full emotions for a full 90 seconds. That's all. Don't allow yourself any more than that. Write about what happened and why it still causes you pain, then write about like what you wish had happened instead, then tap into like your highest self and really understand what factors made this person act the way that they did. Was it certain beliefs or circumstances? Like, what do you think it was that made them act the way that they did? If I'm involved in an incident like I am in this situation, I acknowledge my faults in the situation as well and write an apology, you know, for what my faults were in that forgiveness letter as well. Then end your letter by saying something along the lines of, I realize now that what you did was the best you could do through your level of consciousness at the time in your life. For the sake of my own peace, I am willing to forgive you. With this flame, I consider this incident closed. Then I tear up the forgiveness letter, I place it in a little bowl, and I light it on fire and let it burn. Burning the pieces of paper on fire allows me to really feel that closure from the incident, and it really does work. I really recommend like everyone write these. You can write them to your past self too if you've done things that you're not too happy about or that you still hold guilt for. This just really releases that energy from you. It's not serving you in any way, so release it. So for each full moon cycle, I always do something a little bit different depending on what my intention is for that moon cycle. But regardless, I hope you enjoyed this little full moon pamper routine. If you did, I really think you'd enjoy this video over here. It's all about different mystical ways that I practice sleep. I think I might have mentioned the forgiveness letter in this one as well. Be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on my two videos a week. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!